Many drivers suspect council parking ranges have quotas to fill, but getting their employers to admit to it is like pulling teeth. But now 7 News has documentation showing rangers are expected to be highly productive, churning out tickets for a huge range of offences, many seemingly unfair and very costly.
On the prowl, parking rangers in the city and the suburbs, snapping up record fines. Councils claim they don't have quotas.
People want transparency. They want fairness.
But secret City of Sydney documents we've uncovered, titled Parking Ranger Goals, show that inspectors must be highly productive, issuing fines for a variety of offences between 16 and 23 different types. Encouraged to get creative with 143 offences to choose from, like stopping near a letterbox or a fire hydrant. On a nature strip within 3 metres of centre lines, it's $283 for parking badly in your own driveway. Some signs impossible to decipher.
What you don't want is the public starting to feel like they're going away from being parking officers and becoming salespeople.
The city maintains rangers do not have quotas, admitting they do have targets with monthly productivity reports. Fines are big business in the West as well. In Parramatta, almost $13.5 million in just over a year and a half. Liverpool made $3.5 million last financial year, issuing 22,000 fines, up from 13,000 the year before.
It is kind of being stolen.
Kate Mellett copped a fine for briefly parking in a disabled spot to help a friend in labour.
Her waters had broken. She said, the hospital's taking me in now. As soon as you get here, I'm going.
$644 and no leniency on appeal.
The state government says it's looking into the way fines are reviewed after it found a so-called fairness scheme resulted in fewer than 1 in 1,000 fines being reduced.
A process designed to wear and tear you down, so you just pay because you can't be bothered.
Serena Andaloro, 7 News.